It's a very good question. At a time when the whole world is fighting against coronavirus, it is very sad to see that people over here are trying to infiltrate borders and trying to create any control alternative there, but trying to make things even more tense. Now, there are some people who do not have the luxury to work from home. They are guarding national frontiers. They are working and defending. They are there at the borders, our soldiers. They are, unfortunately, are not able to maintain routine. And this enmity has been there for long. We have tried everything possible. We have tried diplomatic talks, political talks. We have tried everything possible, but India is a very peaceful nation. But despite that, when the motherland is incorrigible, our soldiers over there are only defending the motherland. And this means that, you know, at this time, you will call them and ask me, ये बताओ ऐसे मौके पे इंडिया और पाकिस्तान क्यों लड़ रहे हैं भाई? There are neighboring countries, can't even unite. But this means, it's only going to show that I am very sad to say it's unfortunately, you know, our philosophy, हम किसी को छेड़ेंगे नहीं. मगर किसी ने अगर हमें छेड़ा,
हम छोड़ेंगे
नहीं. So it is really sad to see the way our neighboring countries behaving. Because we have done all that we could.
Absolutely.
I mean, it's ridiculous.
Correct, Vineet. I would like to give a quote over here. The quote is, when you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today. Let me start from 1971. What happened in 1971? We took over 96,000 Pakistani soldiers as prisoner of war. Pakistan, till now, has 56 soldiers of ours as a prisoner of war and denied their presence completely. The Indian families have written to Red Cross Society, to the UN, the highest level. The Red Cross Society, they in fact went to the Pakistan jails to inspect, but they hit those cells. Now, Bill Bhutto had given a commitment to Rajiv Gandhi that she will look into the matter, but that matter was never all till now. A few years back, we had heard some trace of prisoner of war, of indigenous on Pakistan, and they are still rotting over there. Unfortunately, I feel really sad. Now, in 1999 war, when we messed up Pakistan hollow, at that time, it was proved that the infiltrators who had come into India were Pakistani soldiers. And yet, in civil dress, yet Pakistan refused to collect the dead bodies of soldiers, saying that no, it is not our, they are not our soldiers. So we, the Indian Army, buried them with full military honors, gave them the full respect which a soldier should give to another soldier. Now, to 1919, when Wing Commander Abhinandan was captured in Pakistan when his plane crash landed over there, that time, who was helping Imran Khan? Khalil. Imran Khan has got links with Khalil. Who's got links with Al-Qaeda? Who had helped him to win the election in Pakistan? And the largest terrorist training camp came about in Pakistan under Imran Khan regime. India kept asking, give us Masood Azhar, give us Bhutto. China was the first country last year to oppose declaring Masood Azhar as an international terrorist. And look at China today, it's karma. Today, no one is with China. It comes back to you at the end of it. After that court, we gave them a befitting answer. Hasapur try kar liya, har cheez try kar li. And as General Pariyar rightly said just now, that they are incorrigible. They will not change. Now, let me tell you in a war what happens. It is a mother with a son. As soldiers, we lose our brothers. A sister with her brother. As countrymen, we lose our fellow countrymen. But it is politicians at the end of the day who will shake hands. Who loses, who gains? I'm not talking about any party. No, I'm not giving a political ideology to it at all. I'm talking about strengthening our diplomatic and political links, if that. General Parihar very rightly he brought up that he is not saying that this government is not giving. He never said that. He met any government, any political party which is a ruling power. It is their responsibility to see, to ensure that we have good links. Our government tried that, yes. Now, you know, I don't understand why and how Pakistan refuses to understand.
Right, absolutely.
I think the UN must intervene in this. They really must intervene. Because it's about time. The society will not change unless and until we change ourselves.
Hmm. Okay. Well,
absolutely, Vinit. You said it. Absolutely. You know, Pakistan, I feel, should by now, they should have been declared as a terrorist name. It's ridiculous. Blatantly, they are promoting terrorism. Blatantly, let me tell you. Waki jo awam of the population, the normal civilians of Pakistan, I'm very certain of the fact that they also would be fed up of this. Couple of years back, Pakistan mein school ke bachche uda diye gaye the, matlab ridiculous. I mean, bachche, small children, baaki bachche uldiyan khaldi thi. But this country, I don't know where it's heading to.
Right.
Come on, Arayne, as you, when the world is uniting, joining hands together, after what hand, of course, at that time, Pakistan baaz nahi, wo apni harkatein phir bhi karegi. About 2 weeks
Correct.
Back.
Okay, Muhammad Ali Shah, we have a paucity of time.
Sure. Like the way France, Germany were firstly ending Europe only from the duty line of the border, right? Before the eve of the First World War on 24 December, they had a friendly football match. But the very next day, they were back to fighting at each other. Similarly, soldiers across the border are not personal enemies. The diplomatic and the political links have to be strengthened. And how will that happen? India sa koi kami hai. Pakistan ki taraf se zarurat kami hai. So they would be, we would require UN intervention.
Okay.
US intervention, superpower intervention.
Absolutely. Absolutely.